What do you like about hockey?
Playing defense.
Who's your favorite hockey player?
Sandeep.
How about your favorite hockey team?
Mitch Marner, Maple Leafs.
Yeah. Do you think you could score a goal on Cujo? Congratulations, you're this week's City Paul Sports Athlete of the Week.
Adorable baby Mitch. Okay, incredible skills. They're at four. Hard work, commitment, teamwork on the ice all led him to the superstar he is today.
Pretty amazing, and we got to get your reaction. You know him, Mitch Marner from the Leafs.
Woo! Getting up early for us, and we so appreciate it. So how did it feel back to look at yourself when you were a little wee one, killing you on the ice? Look at the haircut.
The videos came back quite a bit recently. That's pretty funny to look back at.
Your hair looks good now.
Yeah, it's a little bit different now, but that was the haircut back in the day. Rocked that for a couple of years, but.
And you knew what you wanted to do even then, and you worked hard to get where you are today. By the way, do you recognize the gentleman on your left? That is one Brian who shot the actual story and interviewed you. Did you see the star talent back then, my friend?
I did. What year were you born, Mitch?
Me, 97.
97. So I have a 97. I coached hockey.
Oh.
I did the shoot as a favor to my brother, and I was pretty sure I knew what I was in for.
Superstar
and I showed up, and he had like two moves: flip shot into the roof, right, and he was going into the net as well.
And he was four.
So either he was going into the net by himself, or him and the puck were going into the net. And I'd never seen anything like that, and I'd been around a lot of four-year-olds on that.
There you have it. And now it paved the way to incredible success with you. Yeah. So first off, congrats on a great season. And we were asking you too, what do you do now in the off season? You're still working hard.
Yeah, I mean, weekdays, obviously, just working out, getting up, you know, trying to take care of yourself and keep yourself in shape. But I mean, usually down the road, the workouts get more intense, harder, and the skating comes, you know, kind of more frequently. So right now, it's just kind of working out and getting in the gym and getting the strength back.
I was talking to my nephew yesterday, and he's over the moon that you're here. So from Matthew, he says hello, and you know, he really does admire you, as does so many, like tens of thousands of kids all over the place. So I love that you're giving back in a big way. Such a big star on the ice, only 21. Why is it so important for you to give back, and how are you going to be doing it soon?
You know, I'm very excited. Obviously, I'm starting a charity event, the Marner All-Star Invitational. So, you know, I just think it's very important as athletes of us that have such a big reputation and so many people around you watching, that you can, I think, really make a, you know, a change in the world. And obviously, this is just one of the things that I want to try and start to help out with. And I just think that we can help so many kids by doing this, and hopefully it does.
So what's going to be happening, and can people take part?
Yeah, so obviously, so you donate, you get a team in of four, and you can, I mean, we have ages from 16 to 50. So a team of 16-year-old kids did a bunch of stuff to raise the money for the event. And so that's pretty exciting hearing that. And like I said, it's ages from all over the place. So it's going to be a really exciting event. It's a skills competition.
Nice.
So the teams are going to have a NHL player. We have a couple girls from the national team coming. So, I mean, there's going to be a bunch of different people there. It's going to be a lot of fun. And we're going to take them through the event and try to help them out through the skills competition. And then at the end of it, whatever team comes first gets a prize. And then at the end of the entire event, all the NHL players and the women's are all going to play against each other and see who does the best there.
And various charities will reap the benefits. I love that you're giving back. And, you know, even when we're talking about bullying online, did you ever experience any of that to kids out there who might be experiencing it at school or online?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, growing up in this day of age, I mean, there's always a lot of joking around and stuff. And, you know, some people don't know if it's joking around or not. So it, you know, sometimes it's it hits hard for some kids. And, I mean, still at this day and age, obviously Instagram and Twitter are a big part of this world now. And, you know, playing in Toronto, it's got its benefits. But I think probably most people in Toronto that have played in this market know that if it's a bad day, that there's going to be a lot of tweets or Instagram mentions to your name. So I think still in this day and age, people still get a lot of that stuff happening to them. And obviously, it's something this world's got to change. And, you know, that's obviously, hopefully, this is a step to try and help that.
Yeah, absolutely. So we want to post all of the information. So Make sure to go to Make Assist for the Kids. This is supporting the Marner Assist Fund at the Marner All-Star Invitational. It's happening July 26th to 27th. All the information, MarnerAssistFund.com. Also on our website, breakfasttelevision.ca.
Thank you for getting up early. Yes. Not only do you play with passion and talent, but heart. You're always rocking out to the tunes, whether you're on the ice or off, and we really do admire you as a player in so many ways. You do us proud.
Thank you.
Thanks, Mitch. We'll be back with more BT right after this.
I want to see Lil Mitch again.